If you want to break a world record, it might be easier to just invent your own sport. Hello, winners. Julian here for DNews. It's that time again for the quadrennial summer games. Top athletes from around the world have gathered in Rio to compete for gold. And while a gold medal would prove they are the current best, a world record would prove they are the best ever. There's just one problem. World records are getting harder to break. For example, in July 2016, Kendra Harrison of the United States broke a record for the 100-meter hurdles that had stood for 28 years. The longer a sport's been around, the harder records are to break. Men have been running marathons since the modern games were revived in 1896, and since 1984, the world record has been trimmed down by only 5 minutes. Women, on the other hand, couldn't compete in marathons until 1984, and since then, they've lopped 10 minutes off the world record time. The difference can be explained by a branch of mathematics called extreme value statistics, which seeks to predict the likelihood of large deviations from the mean. According to extreme value statistics, over time, the rate athletes set new records slows as the sample size grows. More athletes competing means an extreme outlier is probably in the bunch, so after over 100 years, some events like track and field have probably seen the best athletes possible. Take Great Britain's Colin Jackson, holder of the 60-meter hurdles record since 1994. He has an abundance of super-fast twitch muscles. These muscles turn glucose into bursts of speed and are ideal for sprinters. Jackson's muscles were 25% super-fast twitch, putting him in the top 2% of the population. Jackson and athletes like him have won the genetic lottery, but surely there must be a point when the human body can do no better. Some scientists, like Peter Wayand of Southern Methodist University, have attempted to figure out where that limit is and concluded that the human body can handle forces that would propel a sprinter to 60 kilometers per hour. By comparison, the fastest sprinter yet, Jamaica's Usain Bolt, can only manage a measly 45 kilometers per hour. So Wayand is pretty optimistic, but researcher Mark Denny out of Stanford hasn't set the bar as high. Denny compared the historical trends of human racers to two species purpose-bred for speed, dogs and thoroughbred horses. And assuming we follow the same trends as these two animals, he concluded that the best possible time for the 100-meter dash is 9.48 seconds, just 0.1 seconds quicker than Bolt's current record. Athletes don't exist in a vacuum, though, and a lot more goes into making a world record than raw athletic ability. Training techniques and equipment play a huge role, and this is where advances in science can propel athletes to new heights. Like when pole vaulters swapped out their aluminum poles for fiberglass ones, they broke more records than monkeys in music stores. The same happened when cyclists jumped onto carbon fiber bikes, or when swimmers compressed themselves into ultra-hydrodynamic bodysuits in Beijing in 2008. 21 of the 22 records set in swimming that year were attributed to the bodysuit, and then they were subsequently banned for having too much of an impact. Even if they're not wearing it, technology helps athletes. Swimmers train using motion capture to analyze their movements, and their techniques are tweaked to get the most out of their bodies. Advances in nutrition and training have taken the best natural athletes of our species and turned them into well-fed machines. Of course, it's possible to abuse advances in science to gain an unfair edge, like with blood doping or steroid use. There's even talk of using CRISPR to genetically engineer top-tier competitors. With human ability as close to its maximum as it's likely going to get, breaking world records may come down to where we draw the line on science and technology. Sometimes the planets align and amazing sports moments happen. Other times, the ref totally robs you.
In theory, sports officials are supposed to be objective enforcers of the game rules, but in reality, they screw up a lot, and it's more than just simple human error. There are perceptual biases having to do with everything from jersey color to height to player reputations that play into it.
Do you think technological advances like the super swimsuit are fair? Let us know in the comments. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe for a new episode of DNews every day of the week.